Alright guys, so I want to show you a little bit about the radar reset. What do you call it? What's the biggest mission you could ever have? Like a gauntlet. The radar reset gauntlet. I've been researching so many pages. I mean, for the last year, I've been researching everything. So I'm going to show you some stuff here. Now, this isn't even working for me yet. I'm just going to show you the idea. So I have OBD-11, right, connected to the car. It's connected here. First off, I want to close the garage door. Actually, I got to measure a meter, 1.2 meter. Hold on. All right, this is perfect. Check those out. Woo! All right, so 3 foot, 4 foot. So yeah, what I'm gonna show you how you could reset that radar error if you could connect correctly, which I cannot, but I'm still gonna show you the method. Getting a light to make sure that it can see its wall, right? Turn off the fogs. I mean, I'll turn off the headlights, everything. Yeah, whatever, batteries to charging. Ooh, we might see a low message, maybe. First off, I do have the hood open. I'm not convinced that it has to be open, but I see all these weird posts sometimes, like you can't access things with the hood closed, so whatever. Just to be sure. We are connected. So where we're gonna go in the OB, we're going to vehicle. We're gonna go to control units. We're gonna go to number 13, which is your radar. Adaptive cruise control, they call it, all kinds of names. Okay, let this bad boy load up. All right, this is where it gets different. I'll show you the faults just to start so you can see that, like, hey, are these faults the same as mine? Are they not? Let's just look at the two faults here. I mean, I already know what they are. You know, they're just all the normal shit. Misadjusted, vertical. Which one is this? Vertical and adaptive cruise control sensor. I'll show you this. Clear it. It'll come right back. Show you how that all works. I go, yeah, it's cleared. We're set. And then it's thinking, oh, they're back. You can't clear them, right? Okay, we got that. Now you want to go deeper in this menu. Change service. Woo! All right. You want to go to development mode. Deep, deep dive. This is the dark web. Change to development mode. All right. Now you're in, your service is in development mode. You get more stuff. So now we're going to go to adaptation. Boom. All right. There are two things that you're going to do on this chart. Just two things. If they work, you're good. If they don't, like me, you're screwed. Misalignment angle horizontal, vertical dead adjustment. Let's go into the top one first. You can set these to zero zeros. And it's set to zero, then right away you go clear those codes while it's set to zero before you drive it or anything. And the light's supposed to go out and it comes back after 2-3 weeks each time it needs to. But if you can fine tune that adjustment in each of those intervals and get it closer and closer, looking at, you know, the spec, here we go. So you can see it says zero and lines. I'm going to try and set it to zero, unless it's already at zero. I don't think so. I think the top one is. So I'm going to go edit. It is set to zero. Uh-oh. That's bad then from what I just told you, right? If it's already zero, the code should be able to clear, and they don't. So I have a whole different issue here. I'm going to try it though anyway. Let me just check them both first. Again, it does say zero. So when these are both set to zero, it should clear the code and not come back until it learns that it's not right. So I'll just do this just because it's not going to hurt anything. I'll just try and do it. So I'm going to try and reset it just once. So I'm going to go 0.0, right? But it isn't going to talk right. It like never does. Okay, let's try this. Again, the garage is closed to try and give it that 1.2 meter wall that some person said it actually needs. Slide to right. It's gonna fail. There we go. That's the problem. Function not available. If anybody has come across that and found any information on it, let me know. I'm going to do the same thing to... Actually, I'm going to minimize that. Same thing back here. Vertical dead adjustment. Let's just... And then once that error comes up, I can't continue. If I had done vertical first, I would have seen the same stuff you just saw, and the other one says no items available. It's back and forth. When one of them breaks, the other one breaks too, and now I can't even try and set it. And you go here, it isn't green anymore. See that? Because there's nothing to do. So, unfortunately, that garage door did not help me personally. It was one of my last hopes for that, but I am still researching why my OBD-11 can't kind of read and communicate that properly. I still have a chance, but that's the whole idea. Get in there in the special service menus, the development menus, zero them out right there in place, clear those codes, and it says zeros, good, we can clear them. Then you drive for 10, 20 miles, whatever, and it'll decide if the code needs to come back or not. That's when everything works right. So that's a quick rundown. Another method you guys can mess with if you do have a radar problem, worth giving a try for sure. One guy claimed he had it work on Audi, not the Audi Zine, one of the Audi forums. I was just on a page last night with the same 2018 A3, not S3. So yeah, that's just some more tips on radar fixing. Someday this radar might be fixed. Someday. I'm really looking forward to that day.